In this video, we're going to look at the script entity in Shotgun. I'll demonstrate how a script entity's application key can be used to authenticate a Shotgun Python API session as an alternative to user-based credentials, which can be too restrictive when used with automation. First, I'll set up a virtual environment where I can install and use the Python API without changing my local system Python. Now I'll create a script called demo.py, and to get us started, I'll log into Shotgun with my user credentials and pull down the list of projects on my Shotgun site. I'm not interested in template or demo projects, so I'll filter those out. Great. As we've seen here and in other videos, the Shotgun Python API provides developers and anyone with a Shotgun account access to the Shotgun database. But that access is mediated and limited by whatever permissions rule set is attached to the authenticated user or script user. Don't know what that means? Let's quickly review permissions in Shotgun, then we can get into script keys. If I navigate to the People page, I can see that the teacher account is linked to the admin permissions group, which, by default, allows me nearly unfettered access to everything on this Shotgun site, including access to view and change permissions groups. Let's take a look at those now by heading over to the permissions page. Here's the summary of what I'm allowed to do as an admin. To compare, here's the summary of what an artist is allowed to do. You can see that an artist's permissions are much more limited. Okay, but what are the practical consequences, right? Here's a quick demo. Since I'm currently logged in as an admin, I can view the projects list page and all the projects on it, including the demo projects. I can make changes to existing projects or create new projects. But if I log out and then log back in with an account that's attached to an artist permissions rule set, I can only see the projects I've been assigned to, and I can't create new projects. I also don't have access to the projects list page, and many other pages related to administration. Make sense? Great, because my access to Shotgun, as an artist, is limited in exactly the same way from the point of view of the API. Just like in the Shotgun web app, if I authenticate as an admin user, my find API command returns all projects that exist on the site, with no exceptions. I can view and update a project's field values just like I could in the Shotgun web app. But if I instead log in as an artist user, the same find API command only returns projects I'm linked to. And if I try to update a project field, I get a permissions error. This is exactly as it should be. Users shouldn't have more or less access to Shotgun just because they're using the API instead of the web app. So what does this all mean for you as a developer? Well, imagine writing a script or application that can make changes to a project's description field. That app would work fine for admins, but it would throw an exception when an artist logged in. So you have to account for that in the code. You have to take into consideration the most limited permission set that your app or script might encounter. But what if that's not an option? What if an action an artist takes triggers some automation that needs to succeed, no matter what, every time? Even if the artist who triggered the automation doesn't have the requisite permissions? Or what if you have an automated process that runs nightly on a cron, unassociated with any particular Shotgun user account? There are many valid use cases that prove relying on user permissions for automation is impractical or too restrictive. One horrible workaround hack, of course, is to loan out an admin user's credentials in those cases. I won't even start to talk about the security nightmares and practical issues with that. There is a better way to crack the nut, with script keys. Script keys can give the Python API access to Shotgun via permissions rule sets tailored to specific scripts requirements. To create a script key, navigate to the scripts page and click on the plus script button. It's good practice to give it the same name as the script that will use it, so I'll call it demo.py. It's also important to leave a clear description that lets other users know if or when the script key can be deleted, as well as your email address, in case any questions come up during security audits in the future. When you create a new script key, it's assigned the API admin permissions group. User permission groups cannot be assigned to script entities, and conversely, API permission groups can't be assigned to human users. By default, the API admin group represents an elevated permissions rule set, with almost full access to a Shotgun site. Many of our clients don't change that rule set. If you do want to change it, go to the permissions page and add to the end of the URL. You'll find options there for adjusting the default set or adding additional permission sets. Okay, let's go back to the scripts page. If you display the application key field, you'll see a long hash. This value here is equivalent to a Shotgun user password, so use the same common sense practices you would with any important password, especially since we haven't adjusted the default API permissions. At the moment, this key essentially grants full access to this Shotgun site semi-anonymously and bypasses 2FA, if you've got it enabled. Said differently, script keys are useful and convenient, but they can also constitute a security risk if they aren't handled carefully and their usage isn't properly audited or understood by your security team. Okay, so how do we use the script key? Let's head back to our Python script. This time, instead of grabbing a Shotgun handle with our username and password, we're going to do it with the script instance name and the application key value. Great. Now let's run our familiar project query and project update commands. Notice that the full list of projects was returned. If we head over to Shotgun, we can see that the project record has been updated, which wouldn't be allowed with artist permissions. And if we check the event log entries for the site, we can see that the Shotgun project change event was triggered by the demo.py script user. So, as a developer, I now have a mechanism for granting alternative permissions to an artist when they're using this specific script. So, there's a bit of house cleaning to do before we wrap up. Any idea what it is? Take a look at the code here. What part is screaming out in horror? There it is, the script key, that thing we were supposed to be extra careful with. It's usually a very bad idea to store passwords or script keys directly in a file. It's a better idea to store them as environment variables or pull them dynamically from other sources. And what's the last thing I need to clean up? Wait for it. Right. The script key I've been using is embedded in this video in several places, so it's been compromised and I need to either delete or rotate the key. Here's how I like to rotate script keys. I add the retirement date to the name, in case there's a security audit, then duplicate it, trash it, and finally rename my duplicate. Of course, any scripts or application that reference this script entity will need to have their application key value updated.